We begin all new tonight at 10 o'clock. A man charged with murder in Fort Stockton is back home tonight after the county decided to lower his bond.
CBS 7 Shannon Murray spoke with the victim's family members who say they are outraged that he has been allowed to go free. Shannon.
44-year-old Saul Silvas is charged with the murder of 22-year-old Brittany Cartwright after Fort Stockton police say he stabbed his girlfriend to death on January 8th. He was being held on a $500,000 bond, but the county lowered it to $75,000 because they claim inmates were assaulting him on a regular basis and they feared for his safety.
My mom. Mom!
She left three kids behind. Three babies. She loved her babies. It's not right. He should pay for what he done. He murdered her.
But Saul Silvas isn't behind bars anymore. Instead, he's at home on supervised release after the county decided to lower his bond.
There's always reluctance on the part of the judge. There's a lot of reluctance on my part to agree to a bond reduction.
Despite his reluctance, District Attorney Jesse Gonzalez says Silvas was being beaten at every turn in jail, and they made the decision to ensure that he makes it to trial.
That's the bottom line. That's the goal that they're out there to achieve and make sure that he receives a proper punishment for what he's done.
Still, family members struggle to understand the reasoning.
That how could he actually get out from murdering my daughter, and he's walking free. She can't walk.
That's not our problem that he got beat up in jail. Brittany was a human being. She had feelings. And she has children. And she has a family. So he has to pay for what he done. And the preacher said, oh, the devil took her. Well, the devil's out.
Gonzalez says they hope to take the case before the grand jury next month. Reporting in the newsroom, Shannon Murray, CBS 7 News.
Shannon, thanks very much. Silvas must follow a strict guideline while he is on release. He is required to report weekly to the Adult Probation Department. Also, he's not allowed to leave Pecos County without advance permission. He must adhere to weekly drug and alcohol tests and wear a monitoring device on his ankle. Another rule, he cannot have any contact with members of the victim's family, and he has a daily curfew of 6 p.m. to 6 a.m.